Let's solve question number 20. A clock was set at 8 a.m. on Monday. Okay, see here. Clock was set on Monday at 8 a.m. Okay, now what it is given? On Saturday of the same week, it showed 8:15 a.m. Same week on Saturday, okay. Same week on Saturday, it showed, this is given in the question, it showed 8:15 a.m. When it showed 8:15 a.m., when it was 8 o'clock in the morning, when it was 8 o'clock in the morning, okay, means when the time was 8 o'clock, that time it showed 8:15 a.m. the time was 8 o'clock. At that time the clock showed on Saturday 8:15 a.m. so what it is asked in the question, what time will the clock show 8 a.m. on Monday after 2 weeks? So we have to find after 2 weeks what time will the clock show 8 a.m. So first see, we'll see Monday to Saturday, how many number of days? 5 days. Okay, see Monday to Saturday, how many number of days? Monday to Saturday, number of days 5. Okay, 5 days. Monday to Saturday, 5 days. So in 5 days, clock gained 15 minutes. See, 15 minutes it is ahead. See, Monday at 8 a.m. clock set on Monday at 8 a.m. Same week on Saturday, the clock shows the time 8:15 a.m. when it was 8 o'clock in the morning. Means it gained 15 minutes. Means 15 minutes it is ahead. So Monday to Saturday, how many days are there? 5 days. So in 5 days, 15 minutes it is ahead. So in 1 day, how many days? So 15 minutes clock gain in 5 days. Okay, 15 minutes clock gain in 5 days. So in 5 days, 15 minutes it gain. Okay, 15 minutes means it is ahead 15 minutes. Then in 1 day, how much minutes? Okay, for 5 days 15 minutes, then in 1 day how much minutes? So for 1 day, how to find for 1 day? 15 divided by 5. So how many minutes will get for 1 day? 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15, so 3 minutes. Okay, so in 1 day 3 minutes it gain. Okay, so after 2 weeks what it is given? What time will the clock shows 8 a.m. on Monday after 2 weeks? Okay, we have to find the time after 2 weeks. What time will the clock show after 2 weeks? After 2 weeks. Now, 2 weeks means? 2 weeks means 14 days. See, 1 week means 7 days. So, 2 week means 14 days. Means after 14 days, what time clock will show? Now, 1 day it gained 3 minutes. Then in 14 days, how much minutes? That we have to find. 2 weeks means 14 days. Okay. So, clock gain in 1 day, 3 minutes. Okay. Clock gain in 1 day, 3 minutes. Then in 14 days, how much minutes? So, now it is given about 1 and asking for minutes. So, we need to multiply. So, what we have to do? 14 into 3. 14 threes are 42 minutes. Means after 2 weeks, it gained 42 minutes. So, what it is given? What time will the clock show at 8 a.m.? At 8 a.m., how many minutes it gained? 42 minutes. So, at 8 a.m., it shows 8:42 a.m. on Monday. Okay. So, therefore, on Monday, after 2 weeks at 8 a.m. clock will show the time 8:42 a.m. because it gained 42 minutes. Okay, for one day it gained 3 minutes. So for 2 weeks we have to find, 2 weeks means 14 days. So one day 3 minutes, then 14 days how much minutes? So in 14 days clock gained 42 minutes. So at 8 o'clock what it will show the time? 8:42 a.m. 8 o'clock. What time it will show? 8:42 a.m. Let's solve question number 21. The distance between the two railway station is 364 kilometer. See, distance between two railway station is how much? 364 kilometer. Okay, it is given. Okay, at the fare for the forward and return journey. Forward means going and while coming time. Okay, means return journey. Return journey, you know, means we are going and coming. For that we are saying return journey. Okay, so fare for forward and return journey, how much it is? Rupees 218.40. Okay, fare for forward and return journey is rupees 218.40. What is the rate of the fare per kilometer? So we need to find the fare per kilometer. Now how much kilometer journey it has done? See, distance between two railway station. Two railway stations distance, how much it is given? 364. So, while going 364 and while coming 364. Okay. So, we have to make it double because forward and return journey. So, distance between two railway stations. Okay. Means from this station to, suppose from Kher to Chipalur. Distance between two railway station 364. So, forward and return journey means I went and came back. So, it will be the double distance. So, 364 multiplied by 2 we have to do. So, how much kilometer? 2 4s are 8, 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6 and 1, 7. Okay. So, 728 kilometer. Okay. Now 728 kilometer means this much journey. Okay, this is the distance it is given. 728 kilometer. For that, what is the cost? Rupees 218.40. For this distance, rupees 280.40. Then for 1 kilometer, what it is asked in the question? What is the rate of the fare per kilometer? Okay. What is the rate of fare per kilometer? Okay. So, per kilometer means 1 kilometer rate we have to find. So, for that what we have to do? First, let's convert rupees into paise. Okay. Let's convert rupees into paise. Okay. Let's convert rupees 218 into paise. Okay, rupees 218.40 into paise. So 1 rupees 100 paise. So 218.40 rupees means how much? So what we have to do? Convert rupees into paise. We need to multiply by 100. Okay, so multiplied by 100 for this. So you know now, shift the decimal point. See, after 2 digits, so here will come decimal point. Here we are multiplying by 100, so after 2 digits we have to shift the decimal point. So where it will come? It will come here, means after 0 means 2. So how much we will get? 21,840 paise. Now we convert rupees into paise. So what amount we got? 21,840 paise. Okay, so now 728 किलोमीटर, फॉर 728 किलोमीटर 21,840 पैसे, देन फॉर 1 किलोमीटर हाउ मच पैसे, सो वी नीड टू डिवाइड, ओके, सो डिवाइड फॉर दिस बाय 728, सो 21,840 पैसे, फॉर दैट विल डिवाइड बाय 728, ओके, सो नाउ 728 टेबल आई विल राइट हियर, सी आई हैव प्रिपेयर ऑलरेडी. So I'm writing here. Okay. So now see here. 728 threes are 2184. See here it is given 728 threes are 2184, and see here 2184 it is given. So 3s are 2184. Okay. So 4 minus 4 0. 8 minus 8 0. 1 minus 1 0. 2 minus 2 0. 0 will come down. Okay. So 728 zeros are 0. So what we got, this amount is in paise. So how much paise we got? 30 paise. How much paise we got? 30 paise. So what it is asked in the question? What is the rate of the fare per kilometer? The rate of the fare per kilometer is 30 paise. This is table. Okay. Let's solve question number 22. Vasantrao availed of a daily newspaper service from 16th May. Means from 16th May it is. Okay. The price of the weekday edition is ₹1.20. Okay. So, what it is given? The price of the weekday edition means in a week, day edition. One day edition, how much it is? ₹1.20. Okay. And that of Sunday edition is ₹1.50. Okay. The price of weekday edition means Sunday's cost is different and remaining days cost is different. So Monday to Saturday, for which what rupees it is? ₹1.20. Okay, so we have to count for 6 days. See, ₹1.20 for one day, ₹1.20. What it is given? This price is given, a day edition, price of the weekday edition. ₹1.20 price of the week day edition. Okay. And what it is given? And that of Sunday edition. What is the price? ₹1.50 price of the Sunday edition. Okay, so now ₹1.20 price of the weekday edition. Okay, now see, for one day how much it is? For one day ₹1.20. So now Sunday's cost is different, so let's count 6 days only, remaining 6 days. Okay, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Till Saturday how many days are there? 6 days. So for 6 days, how much? For one day, ₹1.20. Then for 6 days, how much rupees? Okay. So let's multiply ₹1.20. For that, we'll multiply by 6. So what will be the answer? 6 zeros are 0, 6 twos are 12, 1 is carry, 6 ones are 6 and 1, 7. Give your decimal point. Okay. So ₹7.20 for 6 days. Okay, for 6 days. 6 days. How much rupees? ₹7.20. Okay, now what it is given? The price of the Sunday edition. Now what we'll do? Sunday edition will add in this. This is for 6 days. Now Sunday edition will add in this. Okay, Sunday. How much it is for Sunday? ₹1.50. Okay, So 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 2, 7, 1 plus 7, 8. So how much we got? Rupees 870 paise. Means these 6 days and this 1 day. Means for 7 days how much it is? 8 rupees and 70 paise. 7 days means 1 week. Means for 1 week, 8 rupees and 70 paise. Okay, for 1 week, 8 rupees and 70 paise. Now what it is given in the question? When the service was discontinued, he discontinued the service. But at that time, Vasant Rao paid a bill of rupees 26 and 10 paise. Means how much rupees bill he paid? He paid rupees 26 and 10 paise. Now, for how many weeks he paid for 26 rupees? See, for 1 week, what was the bill? 8 rupees 70 paise. Means the cost of 1 week, 8 rupees 70 paise. But he paid the bill, how much he paid the bill? 26 rupees 10 paise. So for how many weeks he paid the bill? That we have to find. And which day? Okay, for what day it has paid? Okay. So now we have to find for how many weeks. Now let's convert these rupees into paise. Okay, so convert these 8 rupees into paise. Now 1 rupees 100 paise. 1 rupees 100 paise. So convert these rupees into paise. So let's multiply by 100 for this. Multiplied by 100. Okay, so how much paise will get? 870 paise. See here. We are multiplying by 100. So let's see here decimal point. So let's count two digits. So here it will come. Okay. So 875 paise we got. Now convert this rupees 26 and 10 paise into paise. Okay. So 26 rupees and 10 paise. For that we will multiply by 100. So what will be the answer? See, shift the decimal point. So what we'll get? 2610 paise. Okay, so for 1 week, see, so for 1 week 870 paise. Then for 2610 paise, how many weeks? So we need to do the division here. So let's divide these. Okay, so let's divide these, do the division here. 2610 divided by 870. Okay, so we will get the number of week. See, number of week is equal to this amount we have to divide. So we will do the division. Okay, do division. 261. See, upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Now divide 261 by 87. Okay, so 261 we have to divide by 87. So 87 threes are 267. 87 threes are 261. 3s are 261. You can do the calculation. You can make your table and you can do calculation. Now 1 minus 1, 0. 6 minus 6, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. Okay. So how much number of week we got? 3 weeks we got. 3 weeks. Okay. So number of week. How much number of week? 3 weeks we got. 3 weeks means how many days? 3 weeks means 21 days. 3 weeks is equal to 21 days. Okay, 3 weeks means 21 days. Now what we have to do? What it is given in the question? 16th May. See, Vasant Rao avail of a daily newspaper service from 16th May. Okay, from 16th May. 16th May. Okay, the price means this calculation we have done. And what it is asked? When the service was discontinued, It is discontinued. When the service was discontinued, Vasantrao paid a bill of rupees 26 and 10 paise. Okay. So for that, after how many weeks he paid the bill? 21 days. That we got from this calculation. Okay. Means after 21 days, he paid the bill. Now, after which date did he discontinue the service? Now, 16th May. So let's count 16th May to 31st May. Okay. 16th May to 31st May, how many days? 16 days. Okay. 16th May to 31st May, how many days are there? 16 days. Okay. So, see here, 16th May to 31st May, how many days are there? 16 days are there. We have to count from 16 to 31. 16 days. And see, so the month of June. Now, see, month of June. See, what we got after 21 days. Na? See, 3 weeks. He discontinued the paper. Na? So, 21 days we have to count. Now, 21 days. We got May month, 16 days. Now, in the month of June, how much days will take? 5 days, na? See, 21 days. So, 16 days we have done this from 21. If you will minus 16, what we will get? 5 days. So, 5 days of month of June. 5 days month of June. Okay. When he discontinued the paper service, Vasantrao paid a bill of this much rupees. Okay. So, after which date did he discontinue the service? So, after 21 days he discontinued the service. So, we have to count the 21 days. So, May month how many days? 16 days. So, when we will get the 21? When if we will add 5 days of June month, then we will get 21 days. Okay. So, 5 days of June month. 5 days of June month means on 5th June. After which date did he discontinue the service? After 5th June. So, what is the answer? 5th June. After 5th June, he discontinued the service. This calculation understood or not? See, 16th May to 31st May, 16 days. And what we have to count? We have to count 21 days. Because after 21 days, he discontinued the service. So, for 21 days, how much days are remain? See here, 16 days of May month, and we have to take 5 days of June month. Okay, 5 days of June month means after 5th June. It is discontinue the service. So, we get here 21 days. We have to do the calculation for 21 days. So, 16 days of May month and 5 days of June month. So, 5 days of June month. So, 5th June, he discontinue the service.